Good evening. Buenas noches. Bienvenido. Welcome. My name is Herman J. Hernandez, and I'm chairman of the board of LOCIEM. Gracias. Thank you all for joining the 8th annual Latino Cultural Experience. LOCIEM is honored this evening for the 8th year to partner and to collaborate with the Luther Burbank Center of the Arts and to bring you the second virtual Latino Cultural Experience. We have worked hard as a team to bring to you tonight una serenata a su casa, a serenade into your home. We are thrilled to come visit with you this evening so that you can enjoy 1 hour of some terrific Latino culture and traditions. And most of all, to have a moment from our ongoing challenging days and months dealing with the virus. We worked hard so you can escape south of the border to enjoy great Latino musical sounds. But before I go on, I must say I am darn excited to just be speaking to you this evening via video. It's been difficult for me not being able to interact with so many of my amigos. So I am sending hugs y abrazos to all of you from the bottom of my heart, seriously. At this time, I would like to take this moment and thank our premier partners, the Sonoma County Community Foundation, Sonoma Media Investments, Petaluma Health Center, Luther Burbank Center of the Arts, Kaiser Permanente, our virtual platforms, Padrinos and Sponsors, Federated Indians of Grayton Rancheria, Ayalero, Career Technical Education Foundation, Comcast, Rebuild North Bay, Economic Development Board of Sonoma County, Healthcare Foundation, AT&T, Perry Johnson Anderson Miller and Moskowitz Law Firm, Bank of America, La Tortilla Factory, and the County of Sonoma. Without our partners and sponsors, we would not be able to bring you this program this evening, or even to date, some 31 virtual outstanding past programs to our familia. Gracias, one more time, for all the support, plus a very special gracias to our growing membership, members as well. So let's begin. I would like to give a thank you to the Consul General of Mexico, Remedios Gomez Aruna, for her warm welcome for our whole community. Y un fuerte gracias y abrazo a Julio Huerta, Deputy Consul General as well, for his continued support. Gracias at this time. It's an honor and a pleasure now to introduce our entertainers this evening who will be performing for us. Mateo Guzman and the trio Nuevo Amanecer are a traditional Latino trio prepared to set the mood for this evening with heartfelt songs, which I know you will enjoy. And for viejitos like me, such great songs they will perform. In addition, let me also introduce the Luther Burbank Center of the Arts, their youth mariachi ensemble, the Canteres de Mi Tierra, directed by the LBC music director, good amigo, Jose Soto, performing for the 6th year for LOCIEM. And finally, a new addition to LOCIEM's performers, direct from León, Guanajuato, Mexico, welcome the Trinidad Philharmonic Youth Symphony. Directed by Enrique Rico Asensio, this is a nonprofit organization which serves the underserved community while giving the local youth an opportunity to be involved with music and arts and giving them a pathway to going to a 4-year university. We are thrilled to have them perform, and Mr. Asensio will share information of his youth symphony when they begin. So at this time, it gives me a great pleasure to introduce our first performers. Another great amigo, and a great entertainer, Mateo Guzman, and the trio Nuevo, Amanecer. May you enjoy, and boy, I'm excited. I'm thrilled to be in this mariachi outfit. I wish I could be entertaining to you. Gracias.
Las penas que hay en mí, te adoro, ay, mi linda muñequita, yo sé que tú comprendes mi amor de amor, que sin ellos no puede vivir mi corazón. Como divina joya, valiosa de verdad. Sí, mis ojos no me mienten. Sí, mis ojos no me engañan. Tu belleza es igual. Tuve una vez la ilusión de tener un amor que me hiciera valer. Luego que te vi, mujer, yo te pude querer con toditita mi alma. Eres la gema que Dios convirtiera en mujer para bien de mi vida. Por eso quise cantar y gritar que te quiero, mujer consentida. Por eso elevo mi voz, bendiciendo tu nombre y pidiéndote amor. que me hiciera valer. Con toditita mi alma, eres la gema que Dios convirtiera en mujer para bien de mi vida. Por eso quise cantar y gritar que te quiero, mujer consentida. Por eso elevo mi voz, bendiciendo tu nombre y pidiéndote amor.
Tú como piedra preciosa, what a beautiful piece, Mateo Guzmán en el trío Nuevo Amanecer. Hi everyone, I'm José Soto and I'm the music specialist here at the Luther Burbank Center for the Arts. Basically, that goes down all the way to I'm the music teacher that goes around the community looking for kids who would love to play an instrument and hoping that they can come to the center later in the year and keep playing an instrument and why not do different forms of art. Elvis is committed to being a safe place for everybody. We want you to feel that this is the place for a gathering and our community needs more places like that. I feel lucky to say that that's how I feel not at the center, not only because I work here, because it really makes me feel that this is a place where I can go to have fun and remember about all those traditions that I saw as a kid. For example, I remember Posada Navideña and, of course, our very traditional Fiesta de Independencia. It was through Fiesta de Independencia that we created a lot of relationships, such as the Mexican Consul based in San Francisco. So today, it's an honor for me to introduce a la señora Remedios Gómez Arnau, our Mexican Consul based in San Francisco. Please welcome la señora Remedios Gómez Arnau.
Hola, estimados mexicanos y mexicanas del condado de Sonoma. Soy Remedios Gómez Arnau, cónsul general de México en San Francisco. Me da muchísimo gusto poderlos saludar y felicitar a los 100, así como al Luther Burbank Center for the Arts, por organizar esta octava edición de la Experiencia Cultural Latina. Estoy convencida que es muy importante que, independientemente de las circunstancias, como ahora con la pandemia, que no olvidemos celebrar nuestras tradiciones y sobre todo poderle transmitir a las nuevas generaciones ese orgullo de conocer nuestras raíces culturales, la comunidad mexicana y la comunidad latina en general. Así es de que felicidades por organizar esta octava edición de la Experiencia Cultural Latina. Y no me quiero despedir sin recordarles a la comunidad que por favor consideren seriamente el tema de vacunarse. Yo sé que muchos están esperando a ver qué es lo que ocurre con aquellos que nos hemos vacunado, pero ya ha pasado suficiente tiempo y casos para que estemos convencidos que aquellos que nos vacunamos estamos mejor protegidos frente a esta pandemia y más ahora con la nueva variante Delta. Así es de que por favor considérenlo seriamente. Es un asunto en el que si no trabajamos todos juntos, si no nos protegemos todos juntos, no vamos a poder salir adelante. Es un asunto de la colectividad y tenemos que fortalecer a nuestra comunidad. Así es de que piénsenlo, por favor. Muchas gracias nuevamente por escucharme. Hello, I'm Remedios Gómez Arnau, Consul General of Mexico in San Francisco, and it's my pleasure to be able to connect with you, the Latino community in Sonoma County. I want to congratulate the Luther Burbank Center for the Arts and Los 100 for organizing this 8th edition of the Latino Cultural Experience. I think that no matter what, it's very important that we continue celebrating our cultural traditions, and even more important that we help transmit the younger generations the importance of their cultural heritage and their roots. In that way, I wanna congratulate again the efforts of both Lo Cien and Burbank Center for the Arts for organizing this 8th edition of the Latino Cultural Experience. And I don't want to say goodbye without reminding our Latino community of the importance of seriously considering the vaccination. I know that many people are still hesitant about the results of the vaccine, but I think we've had enough time and enough people from the whole communities that are vaccinated. And I can tell you, those like me that have been vaccinated, we feel more confident that even with this new variant, Delta, that it can spread more rapidly, we are more protected. We need to keep of being careful, but anyway, we are more protected, and having the vaccine helps us not to get so bad and have to go to the hospital. So please consider these. The only way that we as a community go ahead is that we all act together. Please consider seriously to vaccinate so we can help empowering our community. Thank you.
Thank you to our Mexican consul, La Señora Remedios Gómez Arnau. It's not a secret that we all share the same purpose, to provide the best for our community. LBC is very happy to partner with Lo Cien and produce this event for 8 years, our Latino cultural experience, and year after year got better. Unfortunately, this year we have to do it virtually. And I said that unfortunately because I just love smelling at the food and looking at the players getting here to perform for all of you. But hey, we still did it with all our heart. And this also requires a lot of preparation. Just like the day before, we used to put these flowers and the tables and the food again. This is the same, just doing it through videos. So for that, I want you to know that LBC is very, very happy to be partnering with Lo Cien and sending you or taking this all the way to you. So with that in mind, I want to introduce the mariachi Cantares de mi Tierra, the Luther Burbank Center for the Arts. These are my babies. These are the kids that we went to the community and say, would you like to do a mariachi summer camp? These are the kids that came and played for you before. After a year, when we learned that we wanted to do something for Lo Cien, guess what? Our trackers didn't fit us anymore. So we had to do a lot of rearrangements, a lot of new things, but we are here. After a pandemic, for the first time, this is the mariachi Cantares de mi Tierra of Luther Burbank Center for the Arts for all of you. I hope you enjoy it.
pa' mi patilla, y arriba, y arriba. Ay, arriba, y arriba, y arriba iré. Yo no soy marinero, por ti seré, por ti seré, por ti seré.
Hola a todos, mi nombre es Enrique Rico Asensio y soy director educativo y artístico de la Academia de Artes y Oficio Renacimiento en León, Guanajuato, México. Durante 14 años hemos tenido el privilegio de tener una institución que se ha dedicado a aportar a la formación musical, humana y artística de niños y jóvenes. Trinitate Filarmonía, coros, orquesta y ensambles han sido los promotores de la música de concierto entre niños y jóvenes. Hemos formado orquestas, coros y ensambles, los cuales nuestros chicos han participado de manera muy activa. Hemos tenido el gusto de brindar una formación musical de excelencia, de forma que los chicos se puedan beneficiar de este programa completamente gratuito. Es un programa completamente altruista, sin fines de lucro, y nos sentimos contentos y orgullosos de decirlo. Hemos aportado a lo largo de 14 años formación musical y humana de excelencia al más alto nivel, de manera que nuestros chicos se puedan beneficiar de manera directa. ¿Por qué o para qué? Para que sean gente de bien, para que sean ciudadanos de bien. La música de concierto es una herramienta muy poderosa de transformación. Hemos visto este resultado de manera muy directa con nuestros chicos. Se han formado como músicos de excelencia, como intérpretes, como artistas, pero además son personas excelentes. Actualmente contamos con 310 alumnos, quienes atendemos de lunes a viernes. Es un programa completamente gratuito para ellos. Lo único que se pide de ellos es su esfuerzo, su compromiso, su participación y, por supuesto, que se puedan beneficiar del programa, de manera que puedan crecer musicalmente, artísticamente y personalmente. Además, es importante mencionar que esto no ha sido trabajo de uno solo o de unos cuantos. Tenemos gente que se ha sumado de manera que nos han motivado, nos han impulsado a seguir trabajando por generar lazos de hermandad. Y un ejemplo de ello es Germán Hernández y su organización Los 100 en Sonoma, California. Nos sentimos contentos, honrados de considerarnos como sus amigos. Germán Hernández ha sido un promotor incansable de la cultura latina, de la cultura mexicana, de manera que nos hemos sumado a esta bonita labor que está realizando junto con Los 100 para promover la cultura latina, para promover el esfuerzo que hacemos como mexicanos, como latinos, generando esta red de colaboración, esta red de hermandad. El día de hoy queremos enviarles un cordial saludo para agradecerles su acompañamiento.
Thank you. vienen las flores, llorona las flores de un campo santo, que cuando las mueve el viento, llorona parece que están llorando, que cuando las mueve el viento, llorona parece que están llorando. Llorona, 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 tú eres mi chunca. Tápame con tu rebozo, llorona, porque me muero de frío. Tápame con tu rebozo, llorona, porque me muero de frío.
lo digo con lamento, como un quejido que el viento se lleva por donde quiera. Quiero que pena haberte perdido, como quien pierde una estrella que se va al infinito. Sacarme de adentro esto que me está matando. Ay, 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 ay. Te quiero.
Hola, somos el Mariachi Vargas de Tecalitlán.
¡Sí, señor!
Y queremos mandar un saludo a la gente del condado de Sonoma en Santa Rosa. Y también para invitarlos por parte del Mariachi y del Luther Burbank Center for the Arts a nuestro concierto virtual en la celebración de la independencia este próximo 12 de septiembre. Habrá muchísimas sorpresas, no se lo pierdan.
¡Los esperamos! ¡Los esperamos!
I hope you enjoyed the Mariachi Cantares de mi Tierra de Luther Burbank Center for the Arts. But if you want to hear about Mariachi, you should come to our Fiesta de Independencia, where we are going to have Mariachi Vargas de Tecalitlán. This is the most important mariachi in the world. This was the first mariachi, and they've been played for over 125 years. They've been taking their music throughout the globe. With that in mind, I invite you to be part of our Fiesta de Independencia on September 12th at 2 p.m. This will be a virtual event. I know, you're probably thinking you used to do it in person. Yes, everything we used to be in person, but not anymore. So we hope we get to be back, but we have one more year of virtual event, and that's our Fiesta de Independencia. We hope to see you there. If you want to learn more, go to lutherburbankcenter.org, and you will find out that we have lots of events, including our Fiesta de Independencia. With that in mind, I also want to say thank you to Lucien. Thank you for bringing this event to us. Thank you for partnering with the Luther Burbank Center for the Arts and taking a little bit of the culture to all of you. I hope you guys had a wonderful time, and if you're here, it's because you watched the whole thing. Thank you very much, and we hope to see you back one day at the Luther Burbank Center for the Arts.